Ah. This takes us back, eh, boy? Remember Worthing, 98? We'll go back there one day, I promise. Right. Time and mini cabs wait for no man. Come on.
Excuse me. You must.
Why do you have to have that radio up so loud?
Because we're decorators.
My dad was a decorator. He was a prick as well.
Oh, look who it is, Barry Carr. His mum and dad should have named him Wayne. Wayne Carr. Yeah, why are you getting so fat, Barry?
Because every time I shag your wife, she gives me a biscuit.
Come on, Saint. Come on, boy. Oh, it's really nice when you see things starting to come together. When do you think that might happen here?
Dion, tell the man.
The most important thing is preparation, Mr. Mountjoy.
He's right, Sam. Preparation is 90% of the job.
Sam, any chance of getting a coffee in this place? I've asked my dear wife there, but she just keeps answering them phones.
Little thing called business, Tom. Hope I'm not getting too technical for you.
You want a coffee? Make it yourself.
And he's my friend. We went to school together. I used to fight his battles for him.
Yeah. And that's why I own this business, and you're trying to make my door fit. Well, Chief, I need a word. I need to raise some money quickly.
How much?
£25,000.
25 grand? Is it for business?
Yeah, but not our business. I've got this friend. He's going abroad. Wants to set up in the tourist trade.
Who is he?
It's Declan. It's good friend.
25 grand, he sounds it.
Yeah, well, obviously, if he does well, we'll get our money back and some.
Well, I could ask the bank to extend our overdraft.
We'll get the money back soon enough. I've got a couple of policies maturing at the end of the year.
I'll make a call.
Good man. Right! Better get myself some breakfast. Oi! Keep an eye on the clock.
Yes, boss.
What's this all about, Rajiv?
His doctor gave it to him.
Has he got prostate trouble?
No, it's just insomnia and anxiety. You know what Sam's like. So, Dr. Salmon gave him that cassette to calm his nerves.
Dr. Salmon? Jeff Salmon?
Yeah.
Rajiv, Jeff Salmon's not a doctor. He's a psychiatrist.
You're kidding. How'd you know him?
He treated Dexter.
Oh, shit. I've got to call the bank in private.
Oi, Race. What's up? You still doing that disc jockey lark?
Oh, aye. I'm gigging in this big club up in Piccadilly.
I came down your club the other night, Race.
Oh, really? Well, actually, it's just off Piccadilly.
Yeah, it's called Hounslow.
Aye, well, I'm Welsh, and I'm not used to the geography yet.
You got recording equipment?
Only the bloody best, boy.
What about sound effects?
I got sound effects going back to the 50s. Come here, mate. When we go in, just shut up.
Right? Me and Reese are coming off air.
Where's the cabs?
Took a woman out last night, as a matter of fact. 46. Mind me, you'd have never guessed it. I'd have put her well into her 50s.
Yes, darling, where you want to go?
But she was very nice. We got on really well.
Cresta 2-4, Henry, where are you? Carlos, Ali, two cars, Pimlico.
Wait a minute, I've about to break the record.
Customers, Pimlico, now.
You see, men will do strange things for women.
Yeah, look at Barry, he pays for them. Look at the devil.
All right, Ryan. Listen, I dropped that woman off in Barnet, but on the way she found a sort of magazine on the back seat.
Oh, no.
I like this song. Reminds me of my wife.
I tried to explain it must have belonged to a passenger, but a bloody newsagent had written my name and address on it.
I bought this after she left me.
I've seen some of Barry's magazines. Personally, I think it's disgusting.
I was Barry's teacher, and you have to understand that as a youngster, Barry suffered years of sexual abuse.
Really?
Press the cabs.
Who by?
Oh, by himself.
Roland? Cricklewood.
Thanks, Reen.
Sam, is this a cassette you've been looking for? It was lying on the floor out there.
I don't understand. I looked outside for that yesterday. Yeah, thanks, Barry.
Yeah, I'm just going to go out and get a bite to eat. Royce?
Yeah, I'll come with you. We'll take my car.
Excuse me. Where are the decorators?
They're out of their van. Just gone to lunch.
Boss, you never know. They're bloody not. Door.
Just gonna get some fax paper. Cresta cabs. Mackenzie, Tottenham.
Okay, Marilyn.
Marilyn, I wonder if I might ask your advice. I met a woman from the dating agency and we seem to have hit it off, so I've invited her round to my flat for dinner.
Your flat? You sure about that, Basil? Somebody told me your flat is like living in a car boot sale.
Well, clean it up, obviously. A mop, everything. I just don't know what to cook for her.
Well, if me and my boy was coming round your flat for dinner, which we never ever would be...
Fair enough.
I'd be pleasantly surprised if it was a nice bit of beef. Chuck or sirloin. Casserole. With Jersey potatoes.
Better write this down.
Baby carrots, shallots, that's little onions. And button mushrooms.
What about dumplings?
Not for romance. Dumplings make a woman think of slippers, not suspender belts.
Don't talk like that, you'll get me coughing again.
I've got a recipe book at home. I'll fetch it in for you. Rest of cabs. Yes, sir, he's on his way. Basil, wood green.
Thanks very much, Marilyn.
Popping down Ann Summers.
Okay. Are they coming back to work?
Yeah. I thought it best to let them go and have an early lunch. They can put in a good few hours this afternoon.
They never come back in the afternoon. They go straight to the pub and after that they're too drunk to do any work. And another thing. Why don't you get Tommy in to paint the office?
I didn't bring Tommy in. I employed Cornelius. I forgot that Tommy worked for him sometimes.
Gives me the creeps.
He's your husband.
Still gives me the creeps.
Things still no better then?
Nah, worse than ever. But I have a shitty little existence, Sam. I work in this crappy office. I take my nan and granddad's dinner round every day. Look, I'm on the Red Cross run again in a minute. And then I go home, and I cook and clean up after that drunken bastard. What a fulfilling life I lead, eh?
Tommy's not, you know, like he did once before. He hasn't hurt you.
Not in that way. Not yet.
Wayne, I told you before. If you want me to talk to him.
You've said a lot of things before, Sam. I remember when you asked me to leave him and move in with you, and I said I wasn't ready, silly cow. Well, I'm ready now. I'll come and live with you. If you still want me.
In my house. I've got a bit of a problem in my house.
Problem?
I've got the plumber in. A tap.
All right. Okay.
No. It's true. Rain, please. It's true. Don't would I lie to you? Don't answer that. Look, it really is. It's a very awkward tap.
Yeah. Some of the time.
Please, Rain, you just got to believe me. No. Please, don't cry. Don't. Look, there's something I've got to tell you, all right? And you're going to find this very, very hard to believe. You see, Dexter had a very similar problem with his shoulder. It's his muscle here, you see, it goes into spasm, you know, coupled with a bit of, you know, old water retention. But what you need to do is just put a hot flannel on that, and that should ease up quite nicely. Hello there, Tommy. I'm doing a course in shiatsu.
Yeah? I'll get this terrible ache. What are you?
Haven't got to that page yet.
I thought you'd gone.
Nah, been getting some sandpaper for that door. What are you crying about?
My shoulder hurts.
Yeah, women, eh, Sam?
Yeah. What would she do if she had a pain in the arse like you?
Yeah, right up my back. Where are the others?
In the pub. Cornelius said he'd get you something.
You better hurry before your dinner goes flat.
Before your dinner goes flat, that's a good one, isn't it?
She don't even think a bloke should have a pint at lunchtime. It's nag, bleeding nag with her.
She's only joking, Tom. Line up.
You only work with her. You want to try spending just one night with her. See what it's like. She keeps wanting to talk about things, which is just another way of saying she wants to nag me.
What's she want to talk about? Your drinking?
No, about us buying a yacht and sailing the Caribbean. Of course it's about my drinking. What else does she ever talk about?
Well, at least she's shown an interest in your hobby.
Don't start with all that do-gooder shit. Has she been talking about me?
No, she hasn't.
Yeah, she's been mouthing off again. Well, if she wants to talk, we'll have a little chat tonight. And this time, she can listen to me.
Hold up, Tom. Some time ago, I can remember you and Rain having an in-depth discussion. Next morning, she came in with a couple of very nasty little marks on her face.
Did she? Did she say what caused them?
Yeah. She said she caught her face on a cupboard door.
Oh, yeah, I remember it well. That was the night we had a little chat and she caught her face on a cupboard door.
Well, I didn't like it, see? Because if you look at Rain, really study her. She's got a lovely face.
Anything else? Sam? I've got a pint waiting for me.
Just take care of her, Tom. That's all.
Yeah, leave it to me. I'll take care of her, all right.
Tina! What are you doing here?
I need a minicab. This is a stupid little minicab office, isn't it?
Tina, please, don't be angry with me. I know you wanted to move into my house, but it was really very, very inconvenient.
Wasn't inconvenient a few years back when you wanted your leg over, was it?
Keep your noise down.
I've been staying in a crappy little bed and breakfast. I mean me, in a bed and breakfast.
Well, I'm really sorry, Tina. So, where are you off to now?
I'm going back to where I came from.
Back to Jason?
Yeah. Although I don't know how long I'm going to keep him on the books. When we first got together, he was a young and good-looking gardener. I thought, after a couple of years, he'll have his own programme on BBC One like Alan Titchmarsh, only not annoying. But he just turned into this vegetarian pothead, and you don't realise how heavily vegetable-orientated a vegetarian's life is until you live with one.
Krista 49, come in.
Do you remember my lovely house, Sam? I used to have a beautiful garden. I had a Californian lilac.
It's
written by a bloke who worked at Kew Gardens on his day off.
4-9, go.
Please, get back to base now.
Everything all right, Dexter?
Is that the side she slept on?
Oh, come on, Dex. Don't start all that again.
Can you still smell her?
Well, of course not. I've had these sheets cleaned.
The scent may still be here, Sam.
Dexter, don't do that.
I can smell Tina, Sam.
Dexter, this is not healthy.
You say anything, I'm sorry, okay?
Sorry, don't cover this one, Tom. If you ever do anything like that again, I swear I will kill you. I mean it. I will kill you.
Yes, but yesterday afternoon the wind blew it open and it caught Reen straight in the face.
Yeah, Tom, got you a chaser, calm the old nerves.
Nothing wrong with my nerves, son. Thanks anyway.
Still don't believe that Sam fella. I mean, punching the shite out of you because the door don't fit.
God knows what he'll do when he sees what we've done to his wolves.
I know he's a mate, but he's gone too far this time.
All right, listen to me. Sam never leaves the office until late, when it's nice and dark, right?
What you say?
We'll wait for him in the car park.
We'll grab him. You do the business. Sam will never know it was us.
Yeah. Teach him what real fighting's about. Hey?
I don't know what's happening to me. I think I'm losing control.
Easy, easy.
First things first. Now, remember where you are. This is calm centre. Hmm? And remember, I'm on your side. So, deep breaths. Chill a bit, yeah? Yeah. Now, that relaxation tape I gave you. Is it working for you?
Yeah. I don't know how I live without it.
Good. So, what happened?
I beat someone up.
Well, how do you mean you beat someone up?
I punched someone in the face. I just went doof.
Okay, and do you feel there was justification for your actions, or did something just come over you?
No, I felt very justified, but then I discovered that I'd made a mistake. You know, I thought he'd done something bad, and then I found out it was just the wind.
Uh-huh. And how's your general health? Are you still eating properly?
Yeah, my diet's pretty good. I have muesli for breakfast, and then roughage all day long. My colon is very close to my heart.
Good. You don't think you're possibly overloading on the brand?
Well, yeah, it's a bit boring, but... No, no, no. I don't mean that sort of wind. I meant wind as in the... element.
And what about Dexter?
Dexter? What do you mean?
Well, the dreams you were experiencing, the one starring Dexter. Is that still an ongoing issue?
No. He's not in my dreams anymore. You see, you and everyone thinks that Dexter died 4 years ago. But he didn't.
No?
He's still alive. He's come back.
Okay. And you've seen him?
Yeah. He's in my house.
Dexter was in your house?
He's living there.
Okay. And when did you last speak to him?
This morning.
Yes. So, what you're saying is that Dexter stepped out of your dreams and into your living room?
Oh, yeah. That's about it.
Okay.
Where's Reen?
She's not here, Sam.
Oh, good.
She's gone to the hospital.
Hospital? I didn't realise that I was that bad.
No, it's Tommy. Pa about to call an ambulance.
What's wrong with Tommy?
Oh, I thought you might have heard. Police have only just left. They rushed Tommy to hospital, intensive care.
Jesus. Is he on the critical list?
Nah, not anymore.
Oh, thank God.
He died.
What's up with you?
It's Tommy.
Tommy? Reen's Tommy.
He's dead.
Dead? How?
I killed him.
What do you mean you killed Tommy?
I killed him. I punched him. He fell on the ground. And I killed him. I thought he'd hit Reen. She had this big black eye, but he didn't do it. He was off his door. It swung open and caught her in the face. Dexter, I have killed a man.
Yeah, but it's Tommy. It's no great loss, is it, really?
It's Reen's husband. The police have already been round the office. If they find out that me and Reen had an affair, they'll think I did it on purpose.
The police are involved.
A man has been killed. Of course the police are involved.
Shit. Were any witnesses?
Only about 40 or 50 people happened to be in the pub at the time.
Pub? Why did you do it in a pub?
Because that's where he was! God, what am I going to do?
Was there anyone there who knew you?
Only about all of them. It was our local.
So when the police come round to collar you, who are they going to find with you? Me, a man who's supposed to have died 4 years ago. Oh, double bubble. They'll think it's their Christmases and their birthdays all come at once.
I know. What are we going to do?
There comes a time in every man's life, Sam, when he must stop running, he must stand tall, and he must face the music.
Yeah. But this isn't one of them.
No, it ain't. Grab a bag. Sam, if we're going down, let's at least get done by the murder squad and not a speed camera.
Yeah, of course. Us killers have got to maintain our pride, haven't we? Where are we going?
I don't know. Anywhere, where are you heading?
I don't know, anywhere.
Well, we're on the right road then, aren't we?
Let's at least get as far out of London as we can.
Left turn ahead.
What's that?
Satellite navigation system.
At the next junction.
Oh, yeah, I've heard about them. I've never seen one before.
Turn right.
So where's she taking us to?
I don't know. It's not working properly. I can't switch it off. I was going to take it in next week.
Left turn.
Request the one to base.
Where are you, Sam?
Rain wants to talk with you.
Look, I've got to go away for a few days. Business. My house keys are in my desk. Just send someone round to feed the dog. Just look after him. That sort of thing.
Roger, roger.
Where will you be? Can you hear me?
Marilyn! Come in! What the hell have you done that for?
We're on the run. We can't have people calling us up willy-nilly, asking us what's the weather like where you are.
I take your point, but the thing is, this microphone does unplug.
Right. What's your speed?
Left turn ahead.
He just said he was going away. And when I told him Tommy had died, he went sort of strange. I thought he was going to faint.
Well, despite everything, they were friends right from school.
But it was more than that. He was weird. I mean, it's no secret he's been seeing this psychiatrist. I'm worried this has sent him over the top.
So, where to, Phileas?
Well, I don't know. Man of your experience should carry a map.
What good would that do us, eh? You see, that's the most important element of map reading is knowing where the bloody hell you're going. You can't go anywhere unless you know where you're starting from.
Do a right.
Right. Let's do a right.
Oh, yeah, right. Here we go, Sammy, my boy.
For God knows how long, and most probably smell like a tag wrestler's jockstrap. And you look as if someone's poured a tub of utterly bully over your head. Good evening.
Evening. Can I help you?
Yeah, we'd like a room, please.
Have you booked?
No, we're from the Michelin Guide and we're on our annual tour in the country.
Tire salesman, are you?
Yeah, that's right, yes. Travelling around the world, selling, you know,
tires.
We've only got one room.
Didn't seem very busy to me.
We're not. What I mean is, we've only got one room.
What, is this a hotel? You've only got one room?
Oh, we had three before the fire. Oh. Those were the days. This here room, it's only got a double bed.
Yeah, all right, we'll take it.
Angelica, would you show these gentlemen up to the Anne Boleyn suite?
Oh, God.
But it's a double bed, Brian.
Angelica.
They're from the south.
Oh. Right.
Right then, can we get something to eat?
Kitchen's closed.
Well, can you do some sandwiches?
Chef went home ill.
Here you are. Wardrobe. Little table. Mat. Window.
That's not a double bed.
Oh, yeah, it is. People were much smaller in the old days. I hope you'd be very comfortable here. Me and Brian, we're modern thinkers. We like to keep an open mind.
My cousin Barbara's a lesbian. Well, that's what they said at Catering College. Is there anything I can get you?
A scotch, please.
A single or a double?
Bottle.
Right, I'll just go downstairs and see if we've got one.
Well, it could be worse.
Oh, no, he couldn't! Look at it! We got a couple of Hogarth paint-by-numbers on the wall. A day in the life of a witch finder. And, tea break during the Huguenot massacres. And look at that. Henry VIII's futon. On top of that, Brian and Angelica think we're a couple of gay tar salesmen. Two old queens travelling in rubber.
Let them think what they want.
And what happens if the police smash their way through that door and discover two dangerous killers in bed together? Can you imagine what the newspapers will make of that? We'll be the gay killers of Cricklewood. Ronnie and Clyde. There'll be waxworks of us in the Chamber of Horrors. Holding hands. It's you. You've got gay hair.
Ah, I never knew you were homophobic, Sam.
I am not homophobic. I just like people to get things right.
The police are not looking for us.
They're looking for you. I'm dead, remember? I'm sealed, stamped and filed, no longer of this world.
But people know you're alive.
Like who?
You were spotted by Basil Stepson, Mervyn, Marlon, whatever his name is.
Yeah, but he's a Benny.
Well, perhaps under the circumstances, the police might be prepared to believe a Benny. And then there's the neighbours. They might have told the police about that strange, ethereal creature seen lurking at my front windows, the legendary blonde, abominable plumber.
Yeah, but that doesn't prove that Dexter Willis is alive.
OK. Try this. They would have been all over my place with a fine tooth comb. And they would have come across certain little things like fingerprints. And they may have thought it curious to discover the fingerprints of a man who died 4 years ago on yesterday's Daily Telegraph.
I haven't got a criminal record. So, who are they going to compare my fingerprints with?
All right. Then what about Tina, your widow, who you met and shook hands with and who was incredibly temporarily persuaded that you were your own cousin Declan?
The wig fooled her.
But do you not think that in that vapid, sterile chasm Tina calls a mind, there might not come a moment, probably in the wee small hours of the morning when sleep is a stranger and doubt rides abroad, when even Tina, with an imagination as fertile as a cerebral Kalahari, might not just go, bollocks! That was Dexter!
Sam, Tina once caught me in the bar of a hotel with a mobile phone saleswoman from Rickmansworth. I told Tina she was my sister. Tina, believe me. And I'm an only child and the bird was from St. Kitts.
Dex. I told someone.
You... Who?
Jeff.
What, the shrink?
It's my psychiatrist, yes.
You bastard.
Why'd they get it off my chest? I had to tell someone.
Yeah, well, he would have told all the police by now, wouldn't he?
There is such a thing as doctor-patient confidentiality.
He was my psychiatrist before I killed myself. Did he tell you any of my problems?
He was worried about you.
I'm worried about me now. Who's that?
Difficult to tell.
We'll find out who he is.
Right.
Go on, say who is he.
Good. I was going to say who's there, but that's much better. Who is it?
It's Angelica, from downstairs. We met earlier. My cousin's a lesbian.
Right. What is it?
Brian said we got two bottles of scotch. Which one do you prefer?
Well, what brands are they?
Don't know. Didn't say. I'm going to ask him.
No, no. We'll come down.
What do you mean you'll come down? Why?
Because I want to question young Wurzel behind the bar. See how much he knows about local police activity.
Don't you think you'll find that a little bit suspicious?
Not the way I'm going to handle it.
I think someone's opened them at some time. They may have put something in them. It don't smell right to me.
Oh, how's about a beer?
We'll go with a beer.
Angelica, put a new barrel on.
So, anything good on telly lately?
Why, I'm at work. What chance do I get to watch telly?
Well, nothing on the news, huh?
No. Nothing's happened.
So nothing about a police manhunt, then?
Police manhunts?
Hmm. Yeah, you know, are the police looking for anyone?
Like you?
Well, I don't know. You know, a couple of fellas, something like that.
What fellas?
Ah, you know, one maybe blonde and, someone who looks a bit like him.
Brilliant. Brilliant bloody end.
What? You mean you two?
Us two? Don't be stupid.
Dexter, I think we better leave. I've got to get my bag.
Yeah, I'm right behind it.
Run.
Jules, thingy, down the social club. Nice man, never smiled, very tight with his money. He dropped dead a couple of weeks back and left two young sons, one 62 and the other 59.
I'll get you the name of the undertaker.
They do the catering as well.
They wrote a beautiful epithet on his headstone, and all the food was served on silver plateaus.
No, it's all right, Nan. Someone gave me a brochure. I don't know where I put it.
It's all right. Don't look for it now.
No, things have got to be done.
It's all right, darling. Go on, have a good old cry.
I know he was a bastard, but I must have loved him at some point, mustn't I?
Most probably.
I wish Sam was here.
I think it's all been too much for him. He's sort of gone off his rocker a bit.
I find if I go to the toilet too often, I get confused.
We all get down the dumps from time to time. You know what I do when I'm feeling a bit low? I go down to John Lewis and try their gloves on.
Do you know what Sam did? He hit Tommy because he thought he'd given me this black eye. Wasn't that nice of him? Never had a man fight for me before.
Me neither. I've had a few fight with me.
Was that you?
No. Must have been you.
It wasn't me.
It weren't me either.
So, we have two men in a car and the sound of a fart, and neither of them did it.
That would appear to be the case, yeah.
Maybe the car's haunted.
Yeah, it'd be a bit like them spirit guides you get at seances. I mean, most people get a Red Indian chief or a Zulu warrior or something, but you appear to have got some dirty little bastard who farts in your jag.
I know who done it. Oh. You always were a farty little boy at school.
I don't believe it. I don't believe it. When I told you to grab a bag, I mean put something in it. You've bought a pair of pyjamas, a dressing gown, and a Lone Ranger mask.
I was in a state of panic. I've never packed a bag to go on the run before. What would you like me to bring?
A razor, soap, change of clothes, food. We haven't eaten for two bloody days.
I know.
Right. Let's find something. And kill it.
Go on, then.
All right. I'll make a trap. Well, I'm going to slash first. You see a rabbit, call me.
Yeah.
Or a deer.
Okay.
Oh, Sam, quick, look at this.
Just kill it and cook it.
No, Sam, quick, come here.
Oh, go on.
You know what that is? We are saved, Sam, my man. You are gazing upon the perfect hideaway.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. There's your receipt. I think you'll be pleased with the van. It's well equipped, close to the clubhouse and the toilet block. We have a very active social life here at Happy Days. Now, we had Chesney Hawks here once. Oh, it's a mobile shop, calls three times a week, and there's a disco tonight, should you want to raise a leg.
No, thanks. We're just going rest up, if you don't mind.
Oh, that's right. Off you go, then. See you tonight, hopefully. You must try our cider.
Are we going to cook this ourselves, Basil? Because, I mean, we usually get a meat pie from the garage.
Oh, no, this is home cooking, Marlon. It's a special evening.
What am I going to do, Basil?
Well, I'm going to leave you in charge of the bay leaves.
Ah, because that's the most important part, isn't it?
Oh, yes, yes. Get your bay leaves wrong, you're scuppered.
Right, now, Mrs. Marshall, well, Jean, will be around about 8 o'clock. I've explained to her about you.
Explain what?
Well, you know, that you're my stepson.
Did you tell her I flew jump jets in the Gulf War?
No, and I don't want you telling her either.
Why? You think she's a spy?
No, she's a very nice woman. Nothing spyish about her. Just don't want you telling her any of your stories, that's all. Give us a night off.
Righto, Basil. Can I play my Nirvana LP?
No!
I don't believe this. Huh? You get 2 hours, Kit, and what happens? The poxy mobile shop comes and goes. You haven't got any soap, haven't got any razors, haven't had nothing to eat. Sam? You all right? It's just you look a bit sort of... a bit nutty.
My dog will be missing me.
Don't worry, they'll look after your dog. No, Sam, what we're going to do is we're going to take our time. Time to take stock of the situation, time to construct our alibis when we go back.
Go back? Back? Dexter, my dear old friend of yours. My phoenix who has risen from the ashes of the Thames. You, the dodgy packed street tint, a curious aura of a 1960s British film. Hasn't it penetrated? That shockproof, waterproof, reality-proof brain of yours yet? We won't be going back! We have severed the chain. We have lit the fuse, and we are adrift in oblivion, and we must go on and on and on driving in my Jaguar until we reach the end and there is nowhere else to go, and then we've got to go a little bit further.
Sam, Sam, Sam! Oi! Calm down and stop doing that silly laugh! You don't know what you're talking about. You've never committed suicide. Well, I have!
Freedom. It's just another word for having nothing left to lose. Who said that?
Now, listen to me. What you're experiencing there, right, is half a nervous breakdown.
Chris Christofferson!
Remember, we're minicab drivers.
I never wanted to be a minicab driver.
We were born for minicabin. Hey, and you were the best. Huh? Used to take shortcuts that didn't even exist, Sam! I've never told you this before. But you were my hero.
Yeah?
Yes! I used to be proud to say to people that I've worked with no, not worked, driven! With Sam Mountjoy.
Thank you. And I used to be proud to say to people, Dexter Willis is my friend.
Even after you killed that bloke.
Didn't look like this in Marilyn's book, did it?
No, it looks horrible, doesn't it?
Yeah. She's arrived.
God, she's fat, isn't she?
No, she's not fat.
Yeah, she is.
She's not. I mean, fair do, she's on the lumpy side, but I don't want you calling her fat. Remember that woman that came round that time for a drink and you went on and on about your feet? Right, let's give this a little taster. Oh, my God! Oh, it's awful!
What have you done with Basil?
Nothing. I followed the instructions to the letter. Put the mushrooms in, the onions, the tomatoes.
Yeah, put the bay leaves in.
What, the bay leaves? No. It's not bay leaves. It's bay leaves.
Right. Let's get cider.
Yeah, I think we might be needing quite a lot of that.
9 pints of cider,
please, darling.
Concha cheer, people!
Oh, Chris, no!
What's up?
It's one of my drivers. Where? On the stage. The DJ. Pratt Boy Slim. If he recognises me, this place is going to be running alive with police in a few minutes.
All right, now, listen to me. Don't draw attention to yourself, all right? There's no way that he can recognise you from up there because of the back glare.
Really?
Yeah, trust me, I'm a minicab driver.
Sam!
Hey, I'm taking a break in a minute.
We'll have a drink.
Let's get in the car. Get out of here.
Oh, hello.
Tina.
What brings you two here?
Me and Dex. Deck.
Declan.
Me and Declan, we fancied a little break. What are you doing here?
I live here. This is where I moved to with Jason. We lived in that trailer over the back. The one with the marijuana growing outside.
You just said lived. Does that mean that you're not with him anymore?
Yeah. I got fed up with him and the vegetables. It came to a head. It was a turnip masala too far.
So you're not with anyone right now then, Tina?
Hey, Sam! Good to see you again!
Are you two sort of...
Yeah. He's my little Richard Burton.
You asked me to take Tina to the station. Well, on the way we got talking and in the end, I went past the station and drove her all the way here. I didn't get my fare, but she gave me a great tip.
Honestly, you!
Hiya. Reese Owen. Stage name, Reese Peck. Did you get it? Respect.
What's he trying to say to me?
This is Dex, Declan.
He's my late husband's cousin. Sam, why do you and Declan look like, well, a couple of bags of crap?
It was a disco, Tina. Somebody told us it was a grunge night.
Sam's having a little break, darling. You can't blame him after what happened.
No. It was a bad scene that back in London. What with Tommy dying like that. Spoke to a couple of the boys from the cab office. They said Reen's in a bad way.
You should go back, Sam. It's not right Reen's suffering on her own while you're here enjoying yourself.
How can I go back after what happened? My guilt will not allow me to return.
What have you got to feel guilty about? It wasn't your van. It wasn't your door that didn't close properly.
What van?
The decorator's van, the one Tommy fell out of.
Whoa. What are you talking about? Tommy fell out of a van?
Wasn't his fault. The door didn't lock and Tommy was drunk.
Aye, it just flew open and landed in the middle of the road.
The hospital said it would have been very quick. He probably knew nothing about it.
By the way, Sam, sorry about your cassette.
Sam, a quiet word.
So, Tommy got legless and fell out of the van.
Yeah.
You didn't kill him?
No.
Which means the police wouldn't have come round your house to arrest you?
Well, of course not.
Which therefore poses the question, why have we been on the road for 3 days, having a nervous breakdown, staying in crappy hotels and caravan sites, and smelling like a couple of sweat pies?
Because I thought I killed him. Be fair, in the circumstances, it's an easy mistake to make.
Are you Sam Mountjoy?
Yeah.
We'd like you to come with us, sir.
No, you got it all wrong.
We have orders to detain you, sir.
No, you don't understand. I didn't kill anyone. I thought I had, but he fell out of a van.
It's best if you come quietly, sir.
But hang on, how did he find us?
You got a tracker device in your car, sir. We phoned them up, and they told us where you was.
Oh. What are you arresting me for, then?
We're not arresting you, sir. We're just taking you into custody.
Okay, Sam. No need to be alarmed.
Oh, Chief! Oh, thank God you're here. Look, just tell these zombies I didn't do anything wrong.
Of course you didn't do anything wrong. And you're not being charged with anything.
So what's happening then?
Hello, Tina.
You're looking well. Nice skirt.
Look, Sam, I'm sorry to have to tell you this. I know you're my patient, but my first duty is to the general public. I'm afraid I've no choice but to have you sectioned under the Mental Health Act of 1983.
Sectioned? Why?
Well, there was that unprovoked attack on the member of the public. And then there was this delusion that Dexter had returned to you.
But he has. He's just here. But, well, he was here a minute ago. Dexter! But, Tina, tell him that Dexter's here.
That wasn't Dexter. It was his cousin, Declan.
No, you idiot. Declan is Dexter, and Dexter is Declan.
Dexter had dark hair. Declan's blonde.
Oh, Jeff, she's so stupid. She believes it. Dexter is here, but in disguise.
I understand, sir. Come on. Let's go and have a little ride, shall we? And you can tell me all about it on the way.
Yes. Dexter's here. Dexter! Dexter! He's definitely here, Jim.
Of course he is.
I better get back on stage. It's the IO Silver Lining finale.
Jeff.
How's my patient doing?
Mr. Mountjoy, I've given him a mild sedative, and he's far more relaxed now. And I've allowed him a few of his home comforts, his favourite music, that sort of thing. I had a little chat with him about an hour ago, and he keeps talking about this friend of his. Dexter, is it?
Dexter was Sam's ex-business partner. He died some 4 years ago. Sam doesn't just believe that Dexter visits him from time to time. He actually believes they're living together.
He may have just become temporarily unstable. Work or socially related stress. Or it could be the beginning of paranoid schizophrenia. We'll have to see how he progresses.
Yes, I think the next step is to try and persuade him to accept that Dexter is indeed dead.
Yellow Noblet. I'd like a deep pan pepperoni with all the trimmings sent round, please. The name's Mountjoy. Sam Mountjoy.